Yeah, this is so good.
Yeah, boy.
Fifies, it's me, Fifi, and I'm back. I'm back again today with another The Boys reaction for you guys. And today, of course, I will be doing an album first listen for Be Aware. If you've missed my reaction to the title track and MV, Whisper, it's literally the last thing I posted. But in case you're watching this at some point in the future and you're not sure, of course you can grab and find it in my The Boys playlist on my channel. So I'll be checking out the mini album, which is Be Aware. I think there's 4 B-sides that I'm gonna be checking out today. Also, just wanna remind you all that I have literally just finished reacting to Kingdom Legendary War over on Patreon, and I have just started Kingdom Road to Kingdom. I actually missed The Boys' round one performance for some reason, but that will be up on Thursday. So yeah, if you want to watch some of that Kingdom content, the link to my Patreon is in the description. And yeah, I'm super excited to hear this B-sides. The Boys B-sides are always my favorite. Let's just go.
Disclaimer, I will not be reading lyrics whilst listening to these songs. This is my first time hearing the songs, so I want to concentrate on the music production and their vocals, which is my priority. The lyrics distract me from that, so I'll read them later in my own time. There are plenty of reactors out there who will do lyric readings. I'm just trying to vibe. If you want to vibe with me, then cool.
Okay, let's go. So the first B-side. Also, can I just say I love the album artwork. Like, I love it. It's my aesthetic. It looks so cute. So the first B-side we have is Bump and Love. The title of this is worrying. It's scaring me. Let's go.
The drums,
this piano chord, ooh, vocal, ooh, this chord. that my coda? But these boys out, the boys albums just keep getting better and better and better. That was fantastic. Whoever wrote that and composed that, the melodies were so interesting. It was such a weird combination. Like the tone of the song was quite weird. Like I can't explain it. Do you know what I mean? Just like the melodies mixed with some of the instrumental. I don't know, it was a bit weird. Like that bump in the road, like some of the men, I can't explain it. It gave it like this weird feel to it, this vibe, and I'm here for it. I love it. I love the instrumentation. I love that lead synth that came in the chorus, and at some point I thought I heard like vocoder. Like it was insane, the instrumentation. Like it wasn't obvious, but there was lots of like really cool sounds going on in the back. I loved the post-chorus. Like I love that moment that like, I love that. Also I love like the layers. There was a lot of layering with the vocals, which I really really loved. The bridge was fantastic. The vocals at the end of the bridge, I still don't know their voices completely that well yet. Obviously I'm not doing a lyric video, so I don't know who's doing all the parts all the time. I recognize voices here and there, but I'm not 100, like I know when specific people are singing and rapping, but sometimes I'm not 100% who's who, if that makes sense. But I can differentiate between them, if that makes sense. I absolutely love that. Bump in the room. Let's go to the next one. Okay, let's go. We now have the boys. Code, C-O-D-E. Let's go. Oh, I love rap line on songs like this. That low synth. Baby, you're my G-E-N-I-U-S. Baby, you're my G-E-N-I-U-S. Baby, Ooh, I like how the beat picks up the vocals. Sound. I love that! That was so cute and fun and playful. That was really, really poppy. It still had its R&B elements in there, but it was super fun and cute. I kind of wish they did like a special video for that one. I don't really got a special video, but I kind of want them to do a special video for that because I just know from their past, like special clips and videos and stuff, like they can be really sweet and cute and fun, and I can just imagine it. To be honest, I just want to see Hanyeong in a special video for that. I love the instrumental, I love the instrumentation. There were so many little intricate synthy sounds, like it was like, I love that. I love the progression in the pre-chorus, I love the melodies. I did mention as well during my reaction that I love rap line in songs like this. I just feel like they're really playful with their flow, so when you get a playful song like this, it just blends really, really well. Blends really, really well, it just works really, really well. I love the bridge, of course, stunning. Also I love the low synths in the pre-chorus, and I also vocals, that's what I was trying to say, vocals at the end of the bridge a bit late, and then those ad-libs towards the end as well were fantastic. Loved it. Let's go on to the next one. Oh gosh, this is called Levitating. How worrying is that? Let's go. Another 10 out of 10 a mini album. Yo, first of all, I love the piano in that. Dun, 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 dun. Like, I can't explain it. The instrumentation was interesting. It reminded me of something, but I'm not sure what. But I like how, again, it was like a combination. It was a little bit light, a little bit playful, but it was also quite aggressive. Like, I just love that piano. And I love the bass in this as well. That combination of the piano and the bass was absolutely brilliant. The melodies, the way they were delivering their parts, everyone, vocals and rapping. I love how they were jacking out the na 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 na. Like, I love it when like words are like dragged out in songs. Like, it just sounds so good. And when rap line came in as well, I loved how we had a really cool delivery moment, and then we had a really cool flow moment. Just that energy shift was fantastic. The bridge was hands down. The do-do-do-do-do. I love that. I love a do-do-do-do-do moment. The bridge, though, was the best part of the song, but it was too short, in my honest opinion. In my honest, humble opinion, we needed the bridge to be a little bit longer because it was absolutely stunning. Either way, I loved the break before we go into the last chorus. There was also another little pause, a little break moment. In the final chorus, we had a nice sort of, we had like a second drop because of that break. I love that. That was fantastic as well, bro. Let's go on to the last track. Okay, let's go. Last track for me. Not the last track on the album, it's the last track for me. We have Survive the Night. Survive the Night? How am I gonna survive the day with these bangers? Let's go. Don't play. Oh no. Love all the reverb and the. Ooh. This is very pretty. Going Damn! Damn, 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 damn! What a beautiful song! I need to check who wrote that because the melodies in that were stunning. And it wasn't just one or two melodies, it was like melody after melody after melody. The whole song was so beautifully written. I'm not talking lyrically because I don't know what the lyrics were, but I'm just talking about like the melodies and stuff. So beautiful. Also, their vocals were absolutely stunning. They had so many nice ranges. We got to hear a little bit of the lower registers as well. It was just absolutely stunning. Beautiful song. The instrumentation as well, those guitars, the reverb, the echoiness, there's really low synths, that bass in the pre-chorus, just so many, that sound as well, absolutely stunning. Beautiful song. It reminded me of Chase Atlantic. I don't know if any of you know who Chase Atlantic is. It's like an Australian group. They look a bit cringy, I won't lie. Like, if you look at them, like the way they dress and stuff, look a bit stupid. No offense. And I actually avoided them for a long time. But then I like finally gave in. I actually listened to them, and their music is fantastic. And that song reminded me of them. Because of the fugitive sounds, they do like sort of R&B. They mesh like R&B. Oh, they mesh alternative rock, R&B, trap, and like dream pop. And this was definitely a fusion, a little bit of trap, a little bit of R&B, and a little bit of dream pop. Like, it was that combination. If you like the sound of this song, please check out Chase Atlantic. My favorite song by Chase Atlantic is called Cassie. Anyway, I just love that. And I feel like that sound really, really suited the boys as well. It was a really nice way to end the album for me. I know there's another song, but I really listened to that song. So yeah, absolutely brilliant. I can't pick a favorite song today, I don't think. I literally loved every song equally. Maybe the title track, you know? Maybe Whisper might be my favorite track. I don't know though. Honestly, truly, I loved every single track. Let me know your favorite track in the comments. And yeah, that's it guys. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, subscribe if you haven't subscribed. If you have subscribed, I love you. You're gonna follow me on Instagram guys, gonna follow me on Twitter. And yeah, goodbye.
Oh!